Hey guys, this is the seventh part of the video series that I'm doing on painting with spray paints. Now, in the last part, I said that the engine, the soon-to-be DM&E Mount Rushmore C44-9W, would be ready for decals. Well, I skipped ahead. We gotta paint this frame and the trucks and this under part here before we can start the decal work. And that's what we're going to do in this video. Now, first off, I need the paint. So, it's in this box here with another project that I'm working on right now. It's almost complete. I was going to do the video on this, but it's already been started, so what's the point? So, I'm going to take the paint here. It's Model Master Acrylic Flat Black. I find this paint to be the most useful when painting frames, trucks, and underparts of the engine. Now, it's been sitting for a few weeks because I've been doing a lot of remodeling here, basically in my bathroom across the hall. I painted the bedroom here. I do all my work in the bedroom. The walls were an ugly, ugly Penn Central type green, but it wasn't Penn Central green. I can tell you that for a fact. So I'm going to finish shaking this up. Get a nice little paintbrush here. And then I need to dry it off before I can start painting. You want to be sure there's no paint whatsoever on the paintbrush you're going to use. That is nice. Okay, first part, I had to do a little touch-up paint on the nose on the locomotive here. So we're going to go ahead and start with the frame first. The frame and the trucks. There we go. That's looking good. Now, I know I use spray paint on all my models, but there's a lot of parts, excuse me, there's a lot of parts where I do hand brush. That's mainly on the trucks and other parts, other detail parts. Now, this, of course, you all know this started off as a BNSF unit if you've been starting from part one of the series. So, obviously, the frame, the trucks, is going to be painted silver. That's got to be changed to black. So let's go ahead and start that now. There's not going to be much dialogue in here, but I want to make mention while I'm doing this, be sure to cover every vertical area just to be sure none of the original color shows through, because that can ruin it. That can ruin the overall look of the locomotive once it's all put back together. Now, you can go ahead and paint the whole thing, but that's not worth it. Not because you'll be painting areas that nobody's ever going to see unless they take it apart. You know what? I can't really see, so I'm just going to pour some paint into here. Now, I do want to add that, yes, I did say this part would be decaling the engine, but that's going to have to wait till the next part. I'm sorry if I let anyone on. This paint is coming on really good. I'm going to go ahead and paint under here. I know not many people are going to see this part, which is the area of the bottom part here right above the trucks. But if you just so happen to take this off or it derails, the silver is going to really, really make this unit look tacky. And we do not want that. Now do we? That's looking pretty good. Go ahead and paint this truck. I like to make sure when I paint the trucks by hand, I like to get to every nook and cranny. You don't get into every nook and cranny, it's gonna really show up in the completed model. Here. Now, the one thing I should go ahead and point out at this point is that when you're painting something from silver into black, always be careful and go over the metal parts several times, because it will, the silver will come through. It'd be one thing if I was painting with spray paint, because I could just add another coat, but when you're using a brush, the brush will smear the paint. I want to hear what you guys think. Down in the comments section, I want you to tell me how would you like it if the DM&E had survived and actually bought a Dash 9? I want to know what your thoughts would be. Do you think there would have been a replacement for the 6359 and an updated Mount Rushmore unit was released from the paint shop? And tell me, what else would you like to see painted? Try to get this paint as smooth as possible. Might have to do several coats on the tank here. Even out the brush there. Might have to use a different brush here for a few minutes. Let that one. That's one of the crappy brushes. Don't want to use that. Yeah, I don't use using one of those, so I'm just gonna have to keep using this brush. Now, I'm going to have to keep redoing it, but this is basically how it's turning out so far, just to give you guys an idea. This gives me an idea. This is the first time I'm going to be trying this part out. Because that's going to take forever using a fine point brush like that. So I'm going to take one of these artist brushes. Oh yeah, that'll go on much faster. And smoother, I might point out, too. That has turned out so much smoother right now, it's not even funny. You can already see how much better it's going to look. Even though I still have to do that one truck frame over there. Okay, that should do it for the frame. Now we gotta do the trucks. I wanted to go ahead and use a bigger brush. I normally like using a small brush, but we're almost at 20-minute mark in this part of the video. I didn't want to waste your time going over painting just the underframe. So that and go back to the small brush. I need a little bit more paint. This is actually the very first time I have actually painted by hand GE trucks. I have to tell you, I'm going pretty right along. It's not as many nook and crannies as an EMD Blomberg, I can tell you that much right now. There goes my phone. Wonder if that's the wife. She's out of town with her family tonight. Hence is why I'm able to do these paintings tonight. You know what? This is pulling back from me, isn't it? Now, earlier I said of the color I was using, which is flat black, and I said I really like this color, mainly because you can be rough with it to a certain point, and it'll still turn out as a smooth color. I mean, it won't look like an amateur did it. That's why I like using, especially for the parts that I have to brush on. There you go. Went from silver to a black frame with black trucks in only 28 minutes. Now, that would give this enough chance to dry the nose. Now, with the DM&E, most of the unit is blue. There's only certain parts on the car body itself or the shell itself that's black. That would be the walkways, top of the nose, and of course the part that we did, and the stairways. So, that's what we're going to do now. Now, I'm going to be using the fine brush, the one I was just using, mainly because it's a finer area to paint. We'll flip this upside down like I did when I primered it earlier. Now, the good thing about painting this black onto this dark color blue is it won't take as much touch-up now. I mean, just look at how well that's turning out. Yeah, it's going to have to be redone, but, you know, it's not going to be too bad. It's not like I'm painting on, like, yellow or something like that, a bright color, because that, I've done that before, and that's just a pain in the ass to do. I mean, it's not too bad, is it? There, you can see it better that way. Now for the steps. Now when it comes to painting, the steps are my least favorite part to do. Now I enjoy painting on the very edge, the safety stripe, so crews know where to step. That's not too hard, but when you gotta get all the way deep in here, make sure you got it coated properly with the color that it needs to be. That can at times be frustrating at the best. You know, where's that? Here we go. This brush needs to... I need to get some new brushes. There we go. Make it a fine tip again. I just got some emails. There's those dogs again. Now before I do the other steps, I'm going to go ahead and do the top of the nose. Mainly because I know I'm going to have to re-point out or re-sharpen like I did a few minutes ago with the brush. Since it's an old brush, so therefore it needs to be spun through tissue or something just to get a point back. I would like to give out one modeling tip while I'm doing this. For the Missouri Pacific modelers, I want to state that this was pointed out by a friend of mine. His name is Dirk Reynolds. He models Missouri Pacific, and he told me that Jenks Blue is a really, really hard color to match. But for some reason, he has found that the tester's dark blue color, something like this, is the perfect match for Jenks Blue. Now, I don't know if he was being serious or sarcastic, but let me know what you think in the comments, and maybe it is true. I don't know. We'll go ahead and do the walkways. Now, this is my least favorite part to do. You gotta have a really steady hand if you're gonna do this. Well, yeah, you're going to have a really steady hand. I am just noticing I'm going to have to do a little respray right in this area. Well, you know, you should that brings me to another point. Before you start doing detail painting like this, you really, really, really need to be sure that you got everything. And I'm lucky I caught it when I did. Because if I had painted all this walkway black as it is, or as it's supposed to be, then I would have had to, then I found it, I would have had to respray it, then redo the stiff walkways. So, since I found that, I am going to go ahead and end this part. We're at 38 minutes. And when I come back, I should have the GP50 done. And this one will be all spray painted correctly. And the steps and the walkways will be finished. So, that is it for this part of the series. I don't want to bore you with how I paint the whole thing like I did with the trucks. That was just, I think I just wasted 29 minutes of your life, I think, by watching that. But if you continue, but let me know how you think the models are turning out. Let me know. Rivet counters need not reply. I'll tell you that right now. I don't like rivet counters. I said that in a previous segment of this series. I mean, if you're a rivet counter and you think I do good work, great. Let me know. If you're a rivet counter and you hate my work, well, you know what? You know where to go. You know where the door is. I don't even know why you're watching this video. But let me know how I do. And if you want me to keep continuing with my work. And I also want to put out there that my models are for sale. If there's anything you want to see, just let me know. Now, the prices, they range anywhere between, $35 for a simple job, all the way up to almost $200 for a more complicated job. That may seem like I'm doing the easy way out with this video, or with the way I do it, but in reality, it may seem easy, but it's really not. I mean, sure, it takes faster to paint, but then you gotta let the paint dry. And then you have to go in and do hand paint all the nook and crannies. I mean, you do that with an airbrush too. But it seems like it's more complicated when you're doing it with a spray paint. And also, when you do a multicolor job, there's a much greater risk for the paint to run through the masking and you have to redo it again. I mean, in a previous part, I showed you a Frisco engine that I had sold. And that's not perfect because the paint ran through. And I had to go back and touch it up. And it, in my opinion, it's not the best. It could have been better. But let me know. Comments are right down there. Let me know what you think. And other than that, look out for the next part where we will start decaling for once. We are going to do the DM&E, yes, not DM&IR, but DM&E Mount Rushmore-9, and we should also have the GP50 ready to go for truck painting and for decals as well. So we'll catch you in the next part. Thank you. Thanks for watching.